Welcome back for day four. Today we are going to talk about reducing the consumption dilemma. And the reason I call it a dilemma is because this is what brings in so much of the clutter that you are working hard to get rid of. I want to offer you some godly wisdom. These are a couple verses that I think speak volumes toward this. Hebrews 13 verse 5 said, "Keep your lives free from the love of money. Be content with what you have because God has said, 'Never will I leave you, never will I forsake you.'" We don't need to be putting so much time and energy to driving our lives into just making more money so that we can get more things. That is not where happiness comes from. Contentment and gratitude are what drive the most happiness in our lives. 1 Timothy 6, 6 through 8 says, "But godliness with contentment is great gain. For we brought nothing into the world, and we cannot take anything out of the world. But if we have food and clothing, with these we will be content." And it's true, we brought nothing into this world, and we can take nothing out of the world. Everything that comes in and out of our lives is just things that we use or enjoy. So remember on day two when we talked about decluttering and how we must make sure our basic needs are met. It is possible to be content with just that. What causes an issue and causes clutter to fill our lives is the craving and the desire and the rush we get from consumption, from consuming and being consumers and buying and all this stuff. Why should we use up so much energy trying to get more and more when one day we have to leave it all here for someone else to decide what to do with? So reducing our consumption is the number one thing that is going to keep our homes staying tidy after we have decluttered them and found an organizational flow that fits our needs and our lifestyle. I want to share with you what I feel to be the foundational strategies to reducing consumption and maintaining your journey to a tidier life that is also a healthier one as well. So, strategy number one, feed your cravings. Okay, I know this sounds counterintuitive, and I'm pretty sure you didn't think I was going to start off with this. Now, if you're wondering why I'm telling you to feed your cravings when that's what got you in the cluttered mess you were in the first place, let me just explain. I want you to feed your cravings in better ways. You can still get that rush. You can still get that excitement. That craving and that desire can be quenched without ever having to buy anything. There are ways and means of satisfaction that you can achieve without spending your hard-earned money on materials you don't need. Could you remember the feeling or the reason why you bought something? Did you still get that same feeling with the item being in your home? Anything that has still brought you some satisfaction are the things that you probably chose to keep when you went through your decluttering process. Anything that wasn't still serving you or fulfilling a purpose for you is what you have parted with. Find experiences outside of retail stores and online stores that can bring you joy and satisfaction. It's not going after the next thing that brings us satisfaction, because all it's going to do is add to the clutter that we've already been working to get rid of. So instead, find experiences that aren't to do with shopping. Is there a hobby you haven't dedicated much time to that you may already have supplies for, or that you have resources to use to do that? Are there games you can play with your family, with friends? Are there sports that you can do? Are there friends you haven't seen or talked to in a while? Talking to someone, conversing with someone, connecting with people, that's something that brings a lot of satisfaction that we don't tap into enough, in my opinion. Is there something new you want to learn? What can you do that helps you appreciate what you already have? What can you do that doesn't require buying new stuff or more stuff? Again, this is focusing on what you already have, being content, finding new ways to get those cravings taken care of. Strategy number two. Turn off, or at least tune out, the marketing. Oh, marketers have become so good at knowing what drives us, what fuels us. Have you noticed how many web pages are overflowing with ads? You can barely even go to someone's blog these days without being overrun by ads. Even when you're checking your email, there's ads on the side. There's ads on TV. YouTube is even getting bad at this, that you have to watch one or two ads before you can watch the video that you searched for. The people behind marketing companies, they're getting smarter, they're working harder to convert more people in as many places as possible into customers. They're wanting you to buy stuff. they want the sale and they know they have to be in front of you so many times before you're likely to commit to buying. So for instance, if you search target.com, later you check your email and you see an ad on the side for something at Target. So unless you are super tech savvy and understand how all this works and how to reverse it, you'll most likely find it hard to avoid these things when you're online. So you need to cultivate the habit of tuning it out when you are online, or turn it off so that you aren't tempted to buy something you don't need just because you see it, or you suddenly notice it's on sale for Black Friday or some other holiday sale. The same goes for television ads. There are many of those that, depending on the channel or the subscription service that you may be using, it's very hard to avoid watching too many. So my advice on that, if you can't stand it, turn it off. And this is going to take me into my next strategy. 3, for sales sake. I couldn't think of a better term for this, so this is what I went with. But it basically means that you're buying something simply because it is on sale, which is not a good enough reason to buy something in the first place. Remember how I mentioned that with decluttering, you are paring down so that everything in your home has a purpose for being there? And with organizational techniques, you now have a way to store it in a way that serves you? Anything you buy from here on out needs to be something that will serve you, help you maintain the lifestyle of tidiness that you envisioned at the beginning of this course, and have purpose. Getting something that looks neat might come in handy one day, or is a price that seems too good to pass up, doesn't mean that that's a viable means to purchase it. It's exactly what the store's hoping you'll do. Don't give them the satisfaction and cause yourself to be dissatisfied once you see it cluttering your home after you get it there. Remember, the store is your warehouse to buy what you need when you need it. If you hadn't seen that item on sale, or you could go on with your life without giving it another thought, that is probably a pretty good inclination that you don't need to spend your hard-earned money on it. And this is so key, because too often I hear people buying it, well, I bought it just in case because someday I might use it. That's not a good reason. You know, don't simply buy something because you think some random day in the future I may need to use it, because most likely it will be just as easy for you to go buy it then when you actually need it than it will be now to store it in your home until that unforeseeable day in the future. Probably one of the most ridiculous things I've ever seen is how crazy packed a store is on Black Friday. I went to Walmart one year to see what it was like, and I went in and I immediately regretted it. The parking lot was so packed. People were parked on the grass, making their own parking spots wherever they could find one. The items that were on sale didn't even seem like very hot items to me. Why would you flock over a set of decorative baskets, pots and pan sets, another TV, or some other item that is pretty much available 24/7 when you legitimately need something, or you desire to swap out and upgrade something you have? Then go shopping when it's comfortable and convenient for you. Do not go when it's a madhouse just so you can save a few bucks. You can save more than that through the year when you aren't buying non-necessities like you used to, and enjoy a tidier and healthier lifestyle. So don't just buy something simply because it's on sale. Unless you actually need it, please don't go buying it. Strategy number 4, zero-based budgeting. This is something that I've been doing together with my husband since 2019. At first, I didn't understand exactly how it worked, but once I did, it was by far the best budgeting practice I have ever used. And I have used quite a few because I am the accountant for the family. So let me explain it to you in the simplest way. It's deciding where every dollar of your income is going to go each month. Everything is accounted for and determined ahead of time so that unless something major comes up, you know where your money is going and you can make it work for you to keep your money going where it needs to. We've done this budgeting strategy and have been able to pay off almost over $20,000 in debt in just 14 months. Our checking account looks better than it has in a long time. We're able to stretch our money further and not drain our account so low that we begin to panic until the next check gets deposited. Often after knowing where our money is going and when, we're able to keep a check in our account for days without even using it at all, or using it slowly towards items we have budgeted for. I love it because it's given us a lot more peace of mind. With any budget, there's some work, and to make sure that you track the transactions against the categories budgeted for so that you don't go over, which sometimes you kind of go over, but you can adjust when necessary. But after a few months of doing this, it gets so much easier. So I highly recommend you adapt this to your life, and it only takes a few minutes here and there to keep track of. I use an app on my phone to track our budget. I can even access it from my laptop. Now, I'm not selling you anything here. This is a free app. It's called Every Dollar App. You can go to everydollar.com and sign up for free. If you want to pay for it, then the only cost is just to link it to your bank account. Otherwise, you can skip along freely budgeting at your leisure. Strategy number 5. This is the last one. I believe a powerful key to reducing our consumerist habits is to cultivate a practice of gratitude. Being appreciative and valuing what we already have brings us longer lasting happiness. Things don't make us happy, and having more won't make us happier. It's all within ourselves. When we view our belongings with thankfulness, then we become more content and we find more enjoyment in using what we already have instead of seeking something else in hopes that it will be better. Like appreciating my iPhone 8 when there's already a new iPhone 12 hitting the shelves means I'll be satisfied even if I don't have the latest model. Don't need a newer phone if mine is functioning perfectly and I'm able to do all that I need to. So gratitude has a lot of benefits, similar to the ones listed on day one, and many more benefits as well. Really taking the time to appreciate what we have in our homes and around us will decrease our desire to want different things or more things, and will help curb the influx of material items that clutter our homes. So today, your homework: determine which of the strategies that we discussed you most need to implement. Take time to write down or think why you need to do it. What are the things that you have the most difficulty with, and how are you going to implement one of the strategies? So spend time on deciding how you're going to do this, how you're going to fit it into your routine, and how you're going to stick with it. And for extra help, I'm giving you a free download of my 100 Days Challenge chart. So if you can find a way to implement any of these strategies for yourself to help reduce your consumer tendencies, I'm going to challenge you to doing it for 100 days. Really make it stick. I have given you that free PDF. You can download it and hang it up. I have one myself that I've been working on, and you can use this for anything. It doesn't just have to be this, but I really do want you to focus on implementing some of these strategies one at a time if you want to do them, however you want to do them. But reducing our consumer tendencies is going to help alleviate the fact that more clutter could sneak into our home little bit by little bit. So this is totally a way to reduce a lot of that. Have fun, and I will see you tomorrow on our last day.